Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is Sunday, September. I was gonna say April. I don't know why I was gonna say April. That's like the other side of the year. Yeah, so it's Sunday, September 18th, 2016. And I'm saying that very slowly so I don't screw up. Let's get to work. So, yeah, last time we were. Come on. I almost launched Blend for Visual Studio instead of Visual Studio. That would have been not bad, but I don't even know what it is. I don't think I've used it before. It probably just wasted a bit of time, though. Oh, new version of Insight. Thanks. No. Don't use Insight for this. Okay. So we added a bunch of methods to deal with all that stuff. To make it a bit easier to do the what we had earlier, we're doing blueprints, do a lot of processing as well as, you know, physically manipulating the drop-down menus. We are kind of separating that now. To make it a bit more contained. Yeah, I didn't actually add it yet. Alright, so where do I even stop off? So we have all of that. Okay. So now we have one getter and on rep and list of strings per selection, as well as, that's actually kind of weird, why is it trying to get my attention? Oh, there's another patch. Severity informational, okay, so that's good. Reliability, performance, and fixtures, okay. So yeah, so for new selections of the three options, being these folk right here, bing bang bong, and then these are the contents of each of the dropdown, because each of the dropdowns may not be set to the same one, which will be what this list of selections will be, but each of them will have the same possible ones, so we don't have to worry about making them, you know, individually adjusted. Which have one list for all of them, which means we need to have four lists, because like I said, they each have the same one, but the names will depend whether they're selecting an AI or a human. So yeah. So, spawn slot here. And we connected all that already. Did all of these functions. Good. I should look at the event graph just to see what everything is, so. Okay, that's good. Okay. Okay, so we don't have to do anything in the event graph of the spawn selection, because the way we have it set up is we're going to have the screen itself loop through all spawn slots and poke them with the information. Well, with the required updates, it will, each of them will pull the updated data they need from the menu setup helper object actor, but the initiation will happen from the menu, which is not really, I guess, optimal from a containment standpoint, because then I have to do everything from within a loop, but it's easier than having all the logic required to know what is needs to be changed being done in the spawn slot widget, because then we have to do it through tick, and we have to worry about, okay, so what if everything has been changed yet? I would have to flip variables, so forth. It'd be better if we were able to, if we figured out how to get blueprints and just cast out a event and have everyone pick it up. So a good example of that would be like on key press event, equivalent of that, right? So on key press event, if you press a key, the entire program says, "Holy crap, something happened!" And anyone who wants to get a key press event, who wants to monitor key presses, here's data for you to do that. If I could have some equivalent of that being for "Holy crap," the mini step helper, change some data and have that cast out in all the spawn slot, which would be like, okay, let's find out. Then it'd be easier, but I don't know how to do that. So we're going to be doing it the probably suboptimal, but more direct way from within the screen. So create game screen. Ooh, this has not been changed yet. So all of these work. It's from here on that doesn't. Before I delete this, I'm gonna make sure that I actually did save it up. Good, okay. So I have, if I want a reference to it, I can do it. So now we have to check to see if either of these, any of these are new, and if so, poke the the spawn slots to know which one's which. There is one advantage to that though, and that is that since we now have we're doing all the translation from string to structure and data types in C++, we can just rely on C++ is going to give it right, and then we can just say, is this string match what you have? Yes, no. If yes, keep. If no, update, right? Whereas opposed to what we had to do earlier in Blueprints was grabbing a string, being like, huh, is this new? Well, let's see what we have here. Well, this is a string. Now let's switch to the data type. The data type's for a numerator, the numerator version of that. Does that come out to a string of that? Let's do a case-insensitive match just to make sure we didn't mess up capitalization for it. And if we end up screwing something else, then we're kind of screwed. Is that the same? Oh, yes it is, right? So that would be, it was a bit more than I needed to do. The benefit, of course, being that when I click the launch button, Blueprints can just, you know, grab all the spawn lists and go, because it would have all the data on the spawn slots individually. The problem with that, of course, is that, I could just do that in C++. I could just have the blueprint instead of doing all the conversion, make it easy for blueprint to do conversion, just have a blueprint say C++ do this, and then have that be work. So, yeah. Basically, I did something stupid, but I'm correcting it now. Anyway, okay, so. Trying to think here how I want to do this. It's gonna be like this, but So all those methods I can call because they've been created here. As possible names here does a flip-flop between AI or human. Event graph and so following this standard, I have to update all of the type comb boxes, then update the type selection, then update team or player doesn't matter, but and even type and team doesn't matter, but we need to do type before name because type would depend on what we have. And get list of modes. Invalidates the new one boolean automatically, so we don't have to worry about resetting it. We just need to make sure we only call it once. Okie dokie. So create game screen. Then graph. All right, what are we gonna do? Let's copy that here. Let's go here. That's good. That's good. We don't want new list of modes. We want new list of possible types. We'll do this one first. List of possible types. Delete these, move these over. They're gonna end up being deleted as well, but we need to do it a bit different. So four, let's do four each. Four each. Well, it's four each, but it's just a different four each. Get all widgets. Does this make sense? I guess we'll do a different, we'll have a spawn list. Gets children. Let's do panel. Best we have get all children into a for each loop, but that's not how it works. I don't even know why I did it like this. So for loop. Again, it'd be so much easier with a for each loop, but can you do it? First index, 0, last index, get child, doesn't count, then we'll do, there has to be a better way of doing this through blueprints. So it'd be a video. For loop. Movement for a loop, length minus 1. You think there'd be an, like, you think this would be an easy enough thing you wouldn't have to add the extra node in, right? okie dokie. Interesting how a for loop is a standard library. But I mean, you can see why this is very ugly, because especially when we add the this to it, it's like all of these nodes are required just to get all children of spawn list and do something to them, right? It's like, you can easily drop one of these nodes if you had a for each, sorry, a arranged for loop. Hey, welcome to the chat. Salute body, okay, so, so then if we get new possible types for each of these children, we need to, cast two, spawn slots. This is ugly. Of these, we need to get to the child at the index. If it's a spawn slot, then we need to, which they should all be, because we should only be adding spawn slots to it, but if not, I will implicitly skip them anyway, so you know. That's what the spawn slot, then we'll do, what have we been doing? Update type, puzzle types. Update possible types. I don't even need to do anything with this actually. Because this will pull it as needed. Completion, route node. I mean, I think it won't matter if I do this anyway. Like, I think it would technically just omit if you go out of bounds. But you gotta try and not go out of bounds when you're doing array tasks, right? That's just not really a good idea. See what here. So get new possible types. Then we get list of possible types. We don't actually care about it because each of these spawn slot widgets are capable of doing on their own. And we need to update possible types. Okay, so now we need to. Here we oh, is that something we didn't do? Okay. Copy all of this. Cause this this is gonna look very similar. But instead of possible types, it's a selected type. Gonna need because it's gonna be done by the widgets themselves. So that should deal with all of this in the same way that this did. Now I should do it three more times because we need three values, type, team, and name. But before I do that, we need to actually set them up so that way they are added with the menu. How do I see this again? Oh, here, whoops. I wasn't done in C++, was it? I think actually was done in C++. Server side that spawns. Yeah. That was all done C++, wasn't it? Okay. Well, not quite. There was a bit that was actually done. That was done, what was it, here? No, that was done. What was done? Yeah, it was here where we create each time. And we broke it apart and we did all that sort of crap to it. So now instead of that, quick intermission, 1 second. Okay, I'm back. So, right, that was a button I wanted to press. So, we don't actually have a way, we can implicitly figure it out based on the number of, entries in pretty much any of these, guys right here. But, it'd be probably better to have something explicit that I can do. It would be redundant, so there'd be some issues with states, as, you know, I've been railing on for years now. But, yeah. Oh, I'm an idiot. I didn't even finish a functionality, I guess, anyway. I didn't even set it up. Okay, so, need a lot more functionality than this. So selections are fine. That's gonna be handled by, no, it's gonna be handled here because the menu player controller is gonna poke menu setup helper and say, hey, it's a valid request, do it. Multiplayer menus are hard, right? So, before this, let's actually put, okay, so let's add a, T-Array. Actually, not even T-Array, because we don't even need that. In 32, number of spawns. Or do we need that? I don't think we need that because we have a member function that can do that anyway. So get current map, get UI controller, fmap info. I don't even need that anyway. So we don't need number of spawns because that's gonna be pulled from the current map. Bool number of spawns changed. Only. This is basically what I was gonna do. I was gonna have a variable for this so I could just get current map number of spawns. Except that this would have to be done through blueprint. Okay, so yeah, I don't even have to do this. I just have to make sure that, new selected map, would get the value required. Do not leave me. I love you. Let's do this from blueprint, sure, why not? Let's do it over here, I guess. I'm not sure that we can't, because we have to do this. We have to do it somewhere before here. No, let's make a new macro. Update list of spawns. So, spawn list here. And we're going to clear children, but we need execution first. In and out. Clear panel. Yeah, we don't need this. So get current map. The U function, blueprint callable. The category is maybe it is. I'm not sure if it's ever actually called. Let's do final references. I don't think I ever call it anymore. Maybe I still do. Apparently not. Okay then. Hmm. I am confused. I think I know what's going on, but I'm not entirely sure. Source check it private, but he's a helper. Oh. Seeing the old project. Why is it scanning my other project? Ah, well. I thought I was going to be doing something like it was Unreal's build tool pre-compiled something or other, but... Yep. It was determining, or was seeing it from the previous one. So get current map. See how I did it before. Okay, you know what? Let's just do it. So clear children. Since we know we're going to be clearing children, we can assume that's the only children in that will be spawn widgets. The only direct children, of course. Oh, we can't do that yet. Sure, let's save the backup, I don't care. So we need to use this function here. So get current map, get spawn info. Did I not make map info? Thank you. loop. This one. So first index. Yes. Oh no, we want that. We want first index 1, last index to be number of spawns. So we want to apply the actual. We want to count from 1 because it's going to be visible to the user. That's a way we can. So for 1 through number of spawns. We'll do create widgets spawn slots. Can you tell this is getting a bit much? Then we gotta get clear controller. Clear controller 0. So create spawn slot widget. Good, now we didn't have to do, what do we call it again? And I'll be very happy when I can start deleting all of the backup versions I have. So set spawn number, there we are. Node and then add panel panel add child So we cleared the spawn list, then we got the number of spawns from the getCurrentMap function we just exposed. And then for each of the ones from 1 through number of spawns, we create and add a child. And now when we're done, should it just be a matter of just, you know, fixing it out. Pile on save. I messed up an eye there. Crummy. It's all empty, which is good, because we haven't done anything yet. Change these. There we are. So that works as intended. That's good. I was worried if it wouldn't work on the first go, but it was, doesn't it? Okay. So now, whoops. I wanted to do the event graph, I didn't want to leave that. Update possible types, list of possible types, blah blah blah. That's good. Okay, so now we just need to actually have our C++ side. You know, change these. No. Okay. Now we need the functionality in C++ to populate these arrays of strings, as I said. Which means we need a function to change that. Function void. Update, list types. Update list of teams. Function. List of players. New function. Void update. List of human names. Updates list of types. I'm not sure if I'm gonna need parameters or not. I don't think I will, but I just want to make sure I actually, you know, do some work. I think I originally made this game thinking it would be a weekend job. I mean, not nearly as complex, and also I didn't realize how much time would be sucked up by, you know, doing the stream, which is good, but, you know. string. Possible. Types equals come on, IntelliSense, I need your help. Because there's a functionality in Blueprints to get a list of strings from all possible values. Enum to string C++ UE4. Okay, it's very clanky if you just need to add the unit. Hopefully this has been updated to use enum classes. Yeah, it does use enum classes, it's good. Okay, that's annoying. So const enum pointer, find object uenum, any package text vector. Okay, this is looking pretty bad. So I'm probably gonna hard code it. This is where we start getting nasty things happening, by the way. This is not a good practice to get into, but I don't really have any other options at the moment. I should do a, if role equals role authority. Or this thing I really need to do. Authority. I guess has authority is the thing I'm doing. Okay. Okay, and then list of possible types equals possible types. What am I even doing this for? And then if it's authority, then we'll do on rep the list of possible types. Okay. So if has authority. The reason why we're doing a has authority check is because, well, if we don't have authority, then it's just going to be replicated across the network eventually, right? So, yeah. The update only needs to happen server side. Let's check something here. Get current map. It requires game instance. Base one is for map info. Number of spawns probably defaults to 0. That's probably wrong. Because there will never be a case where number of spawns doesn't equal number of spawns unless we change that. Which means I'm going to have to recompile that entire crap now. Assign integer initializes to 0, right? Sure, why not? Okay. Count equals get current map dot number of spawns. This could be negative or 0 if someone screwed up this value. So we have to be careful with that. So 4 and 3 2, I equals 0, I less than spawn count. I plus plus, and we were careful because if this is 0 or less, then it will never run. We'll just skip through this. list of possible teams.empty. List of possible teams.add. I guess we can't do that right away. F string, current team name equals text team, and that space is intentional. Current team name plus, plus equals, or dot append. I plus one. That's actually not necessary at all. I'm used to putting brackets around a bunch of things. Even when I was in school, like even when I was in elementary school, I used to put way unnecessary brackets. Well, elementary school, junior high, late elementary school. I used to put unnecessary brackets around as many things as I could just to make sure that the order of operations were absolutely clear. I mean, why would I do that? Depends. but yeah. I want to be clear, I'll just say that much. So we don't want to increment, we just want to get it, the next one. So. And then, oh, what am I doing? List of possible teams dot add. On rep, list of possible teams. And again, this is because, same with this. This is called on replication, so whenever the variable, the lists, goes from the server to all the clients, that replication will occur. And on rep list of, well, these two functions will be called in that process. The server won't have that level tree, so on the server, we have to make sure it's called through our function that changes it. So whenever we change something on the server, we have to make sure we call the, still on the server, the function to change it. Because otherwise the replication value won't happen. Unless for some reason we don't ever need, I mean we really kind of don't, but if we didn't ever need to have the value on the server replicate off to all the clients, then we would have to deal with it, right? We would just, if the onRep function is irrelevant for the server, so when the value changes, the server doesn't need to know when the value changed, then we don't need to call it. I don't even know what I was talking about earlier. But chances are, not chances are, but in this situation, when I change that value, I want to do something on that value change. Probably, well in this case, probably just switching a variable to say, hey, here's a new variable for the blueprints to pick up. But if I, you know, had more complex logic for that, I would have that there and have that be. If it has to happen the same on a server and the client, then when the variable changes, then I'll have it in the on variable change command and just call that method from the server, if in the server's case. I think that actually made sense. Okay. Now this one's gonna be annoying, because update list of possible human names is going to be getting the game state and getting the game state and can't speak. And getting the list of names from it, so. Well, getting a list of player states from it, and then getting the list of names from them. And getting a name from each of them, I should say. So, if has authority. A game states. Equals use gameplay statics game states. Yes. T array a player state pointer. Player states equals GS player states player array. That's right. Yeah, okay. I shouldn't even do that. Because instead of doing player states, you can just do GS player array. So, for F string, current name, and GS player array, okay, that's right. A player states, that's the thing. Current state, player state. Do current PS. List of possible human names. Dot empty. Names dot add current PS dot not dot it's a pointer, it's an object, not a structure. Name. That was good player name. It's just player name. So we add all that, and then on rep, list of possible names. Nope. There we are. Right. If has authority. This one will be a lot easier. It'll be exactly like this one, just a fake list. I'll eventually probably have it tied into the AI system, but I'll just have some standard names here. We'll have it be Alice, Bob, Charlie, I think you probably guessed the algorithm. Well, see what the algorithm is. You may not be able to guess what this name is. These will change over time, but right. And we're about to call it for today. Hey, welcome to the chat. It's gonna be a long compile because we changed checkit types to include this little fix here. Question: would get game state if you gave it null, crash or just return a null? Because we're doing a null check for the result here. I should check it out later on, but obviously not right now. Now we actually have values here, so it should, I'm not sure, will it update? I don't know if I changed that yet. No, I guess it didn't, okay. So I didn't actually call it yet. Actually, list of possible types should work. So why didn't that work? Types. Oh, because they're never called. Okay, yeah, that explains it. I made these functions, I never actually called them. Right. Okay, well, I think it's probably going to be the last of it, but let's try doing this before we go. So, some of them we can do on begin play, so process list of modes, and then we'll also have update list of possible types, because that's done once. an update list of possible AI names. But teams and human names. You know what? Let's just do human names there. Actually, it's not even really the right place to do it anyway. Server select map. Try this again, see if this works. If it doesn't, it's fine, because I have to go in like 5 minutes, so yeah, that's right, half hour early today, but you know, I also started a little bit early too, so it works out in the wash. Or not. Well, we'll figure that out next time. For now, I want to say thanks for watching and see you next time.